welcome to another edition of Amigos Plays. It's been a while, and so we're going to tackle Jimmy's fantastic journey today. This was a game that was suggested by a guy named Wendell. I don't know anything about him, but he sent me an email and he said, "Why don't you check out Jimmy's fantastic journey?" So I said, "Okay." So, first thing I did was I went in and remapped my controls, as I do, to map the jump to a button and not up. I'm just too much of a console gamer to live with the up jump. Man, this is it's a little unforgiving, but no jumping on the guys, I guess. I'm just gonna lose this last life and start again from the top. I like the music. Euro Power Pack. A melon design game. Design spelled cool guy style. House of Fun. We'll see how much fun it is. Okay, this time I'm bound and determined to get farther. The way those balloons are, it's almost like you can ride on them. Oh man, even the explosions have some residual effect that will kill you. So those wood things will disappear. We just gotta keep jumping. There we go. Got a punching bag. May or may not be indestructible. Okay. Collect our tarts. You know, I don't know why tarts aren't a bigger thing in the US. I like a good cherry tart. Egg tarts are a thing. That's a big thing. When I was in China, egg tarts were on the menu at KFC. It was a huge thing. People go crazy for them. I didn't have any egg tarts when I was in KFC in China. Okay, so now we run into... I guess they can give you a little lift, you just can't ride up on them bubble style. Some fish bowls I couldn't collect. I'm sure this was I didn't check to see what year this came out, but it's gotta be a late release. It looks really good. Oh shoot. Sometimes I forget that everything kills you. Even things that look kinda innocuous. Music's very good. Come on. You really gotta plan what you're doing. See, that thing looks so cute. That thing should not be able to kill you. It looks like Super Frog. Anything else coming? Tasty drinks. Can I get up there? Ooh, I might as well. Things are okay down here, too. Ooh, chainsaw coming at me. We'll try this again. that thing in midair. I know it's coming. Watch out. That is just, it's so, that's cheap, and I hate it. That plane, I've died more times. And the thing is, you know, you've already died so many times, it's almost like, why not even try and continue on, because there's no extra lives. I don't think 2 mana is going to be enough to get me through to the next stage, though I could be wrong. And there's weird things like this guy, who doesn't attack you, yet it's very strong. Oh, come on. Your bubble's got a strange amount of travel. I was checking to see if your momentum had anything to do with it. Skipping the tarts. Moving on. I really wanted to see if that alcohol did anything. May check to see if there's any kind of a stage select available. Alright, sorry about that break, everybody. I just got a call saying that school has been canceled tomorrow. So some of you might recall that I'm a band director in middle school, and I don't blame them for canceling school. It is not good out there. We just had a couple days of very, very cold weather, and it's not safe. I laugh because it's the same thing that killed me last time. I should have known better. And I almost feel like just want to throw these out in front of me wherever I go. I did do some research while I was gone. Oh, little magic door. This game was published in 1995 by Lionheart Software. Which is funny because we just did Lionheart a couple days ago. This being a 1995 release, came out, you know, after the Amiga was technically done. I'm sure it's an AGA. Well, I don't want to say that. I didn't check on the Amiga to see if it was an AGA title. Ooh, floppy disks down there. But they put them down there, maybe like as a trap. I don't know. I feel like it would be hard to get back up there, although we'll try it. And then you gotta just kinda ride these things to freedom. I knew this would happen. Although it's not that difficult. I'm curious about that yellow door that opens and those eyes peek out. Maybe it's just a... Okay, so, made it to the end of the first stage. House of Fun stage 1.2. Oh, forget that you can't jump on enemies. You know, that's, in a Mario clone, you need to be able to jump on enemies. I'm sorry, the Addams Family, they did it right. Oh, but I do like the balloon thing, even though it is slightly infuriating, because when you... I could hit that. I swear that's, you know, there's an enemy in Super Frog that looks just like that. Y'all know what I'm talking about. If you're watching Amigos Plays, you've played Super Frog. I've got 0 lives left. I hope that there's some sort of a continue. what would be great is if there were a one-up somewhere. I guess those might be checkpoints. I don't know. Can I push up? Well, I guess up is now remapped to the jump button. But I just wonder what that's about. I like the fish outside. It's a neat thing. But here we are again at stage 1.1. Maybe this time I'll be able to conserve my lives a little bit better. I did also read that there are 36 levels in this game, which makes it a big game. I think there's about as many levels in Mr. Beanbag. Of course, you know, there's no comparison. Mr. Beanbag is the vastly superior title. But this little guy, Jimmy, he is well animated. So I appreciate that. You know, for an Amiga fan in 1995, I bet it felt like the world was just, the world was collapsing around you because your beloved machine had gone, you know, Commodore had gone out of business. I guess, you know, SCOM was manufacturing machines. After that, stupid one-hit kills. Maybe, you know, if you were around back then, maybe this brought a little happiness into your life. I hope it did. Alright, triangle face. There's another one. Oh, shoot. You can go backwards in this game, which is, you know, a thing that you can do. Yeah, those have got to be checkpoints. Man. And, you know, they tempt you, I see this now, they tempt you with those tasty treats, but if you go this way, the flying chainsaws do not get you, so, and the arrow tells you to go that way, so, I don't remember this from last time, looks like a apothecary thing, nothing gives you extra lives though, you get a bunch of points that you can't do anything with. Was this? Ooh. I like that. I was gonna say maybe I don't like it quite as much as the game bugs out. Could this be a? You know, it's impossible to. Oh, and they've got the spikes there. I just know it, but this is not going to end well. Shoot, can't jump on, guys. Now, I wonder if I go back, will the flying chainsaws respawn? Well, maybe if I went back farther. I thought maybe one of those things I hadn't collected yet. Music's catchy. I like it. This is not the way to do that. It's those spikes that make me nervous. Okay. This is where I don't die. Just drop down. See, I managed to skip this the first time through when I found that hidden area. it's odd. There's a lot of things that are odd about this game. Like some playing cards. You know, this game is very much like Zool, in that they just had, I guess, just so many different designs for things, and they just threw them all in. You know, everything gives you a certain, you know, number of points that multiplies as you pick them up in rapid succession. But end of the first stage. Some nice little parallax things. Whew, it's almost over right there. Where I died last time. Oh. So let's try and destroy this guy. Oh, that. Well, alrighty then. Go on. Is an annoying sound. Now, I swear there was something. It's just, this whole thing makes me nervous. Oh, I forgot you don't run into the ceilings of things, so it's a small mercy. Read on the Minamiga that at the end of the 36 levels, there's no boss. There are no bosses in this game at all. You just get congratulations and game over. Now, what do you think the chances are that that thing just starts moving right towards me once I go onto that ledge? We're going to skip it all together. I think something told that routine to not start. I had a feeling something might have been under there. That looks a great deal of fun. And that's it, folks. That was Jimmy's fantastic journey. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you like platformers and you like the Amiga trademarks of pseudo cheap deaths and long levels, then you'll enjoy it. We'll see you next time for another edition of Amigos Plays.